When was the last time you said no to God? Do you remember a moment like that? Do you remember an experience? Do you remember a moment of suffering when you said, I can't do this anymore. I can't do this anymore. The Talmud has pockets of places to go to sit, to learn. And the Gemara Brachot, Daf Hei, 5a and b, that's a headquarters for suffering. Yisurim, suffering, Yisurim shel Ahava. Suffering, that's an expression of God's love. Can you imagine that? And there's a wonderful machloket, a controversy between Rabbi Yaakov and Rabbi Acha Bar Idi. One says, I can endure anything as long as I can pray. And one says, I can endure anything as long as I can learn. Kol she'en ben bitul Torah, kol she'en ben bitul tefillah. So what for you would that be? I can endure as long as we each have a different response to that. What's your response? One of God's names is Shaddai, Shin Dalet Yud, and the Talmud says, Sha'amar le'olamot dai, enough. When do we evoke that name of the divine and say enough? Here we are. Parashat Chayei Sarah. V'yi Chayei Sarah, 100 shana, 20 shana, v'shev shanim, shnei Chayei Sarah, and Sarah lived 100 years and 20 years and 7 years, the years of her life. And the Piyasetz Nerebe, in his book, Esh Kodesh, Holy Fire, teachings that he gave over in the Warsaw Ghetto. It's not the only teachings that he left us. He left us many teachings from before the war. Tzav Ezerus, his spiritual journal, Derech HaMelech and the Torah portions, obligations of the students, Chovat Talmidim, conscious community. But here, he teaches us Sarah. She says, Master of the world, she hears the Akedah, and I can't do this. I can't endure this. Why is it? And the Piyasetz Nerebe says, two things. He says, one, להמליץ טוב בעדינו, להראות שעל ידי יסורים חס ושלום יותר מדי, מה נעשה? She says, he says that she's evoking God's consciousness to say, right, we can't do this. Maybe I can endure this, but if I endure this, you'll think that it's okay. And I can't do this. I can't sacrifice a child. And even more so, he goes even further and says, שעד שפרחה נשמתה לטובת ישראל עשתה, להראות להשם איך אי אפשר לישראל לסבול ישראל יותר מדי. She did this intentionally. She did this intentionally to show God, this is impossible. This is too much. And when in our life are those moments that we come so close to saying, Master of the world, Divine Mother, too much, too hard. Don't ask this of me. I can't endure this. And then Sarah teaches us it's okay to say no. It's okay to say, I can't do this. She takes her life, so to speak. She says, I can't do this. What are those moments in our life that we feel, Master of the world, I can't? And you know, Sarah is also teaching us, saying no to God is an act of love. Saying no to God is a relationship with God, is belief in God, is faith in God. It's important that we hold on to that as well. And don't think that our no is a failure. Sometimes our no is actually a statement of our strength. So what are those moments? God forbid we should know from these moments. I pray that we never know. But the Piyasetz Nerebe is also telling us when we're confronted in those moments that we have the virtue of Sarah Imenu, Sarah our matriarch, to say to God, no, too much. I can't endure this. They're both acts of love. Shavua Tov from Shechter, and may we never know suffering.